Hey guys, my name is Mark. I'm the founder of Backendless. I often get the question of what is Backendless? For a platform that can do so much, answering that question and satisfying someone's technical interest and curiosity is not an easy task. I'm going to try to answer that question now. The best way to think about Backendless is to approach it from the perspective of thinking what an application consists of. And any mobile or web application, most of them, consists of two top-level components. There's a client side, which is the front end, and there's a server side, which is the back end. And front end and the back end, they integrate with each other. The front end, or the client side, is responsible for user interface, for the user experience. It captures data from the user. It presents choices to the user to click or make selections or whatever. So the understanding of what the front end is about is pretty clear. Everyone understands user interfaces because that's what we see on the on our screens of the mobile devices or in the browser. Now the back end is also responsible for a fairly finite set of things. After all, that's where the database is, where the files are, that's where the user information is stored, where this that's where the security policies are being configured. So that's the back end. And Backendless, now that we know that there is client side and the server side, is really both. And you would ask, how is it? Well, first of all, you can use Backendless any way you want to. You can use it strictly as the front end, or you can use it strictly as the back end. Let's consider both cases. So when you use Backendless as the back end, you rely on Backendless to provide all the server side functionality. So that you would consume it as the database. You would consume it as the system that can send out push notifications. You would consume it as a system where you can upload files and perform some file-related operations. That's strictly the backend. In order to use Backendless that way, we provide APIs in the form of SDKs or REST API. And if you take one of our SDKs, they're all open source, by the way, and we have multiple for Android, for iOS, for JavaScript, for Flutter, for .NET. So all those SDKs are available in open source. You can take that SDK, embed it into your application, and consume backend through the APIs. And Backendless provides all the servers, all the infrastructure, highly scalable. You basically don't need to worry about the servers. What about the front end? Well, as of late, Backendless provides a system where you can build user interfaces right in the browser without downloading anything, create mobile or web applications through drag and drop without any coding to basically create your front end, to create your user interfaces and integrate them with the server side. And that client-side system is called UI Builder. It is now part of Backendless. And here, essentially going over what I just said, you can consume Backendless as the backend, you can use Backendless to build your applications, or you can do it both of those things. You can create user interfaces in Backendless and use the backend that is right there, essentially creating a complete application all within Backendless. And when you do this, you can do it completely without any coding, both client-side and the server-side. And since everything, the whole process of building applications is done visually, we call Backendless Visual Application Development Platform. But keep in mind, you don't have to use it. You can actually use Backendless strictly as the backend. But we believe that building applications, especially if you do it without any coding, is the simplest way to actually create highly scalable, beautiful applications that are out there running on in the browser or mobile devices. So the shortest answer of what is Backendless is going to be it is a visual application development platform. I hope this answers the question if you were wondering what Backendless is. If not, let us know. We're listening on our support forum, Slack channel. Just shoot us an email. We'll be happy to get this conversation going. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy coding.